It is Election Day, and you have just 2 hours left to cast your vote before polling places close. Good evening, I'm Daniel Nguyen.
And I'm Dana Clemens. Right now, voters across mid-Missouri are weighing in on some controversial races. We have crews checking in at polling places in both Columbia and Jefferson City.
ABC 17's Lindsay Henry is standing by in Jefferson City tonight, but first, let's kick off our Vote 2014 coverage with ABC 17's Heather Horrigan live at the Columbia Library. And Heather, how has voting been going here today in Boone County?
Well, Daniel, this is certainly the busiest time for the polls with 2 hours left, and that is the case here at the library. Parking was close to impossible when I came out here just a couple of minutes ago. It has been very crowded as far as those voting inside. There's not a line yet, but there has been a steady flow of people in and out, and that is picking up as people are starting to get off work. Now, at noon today, there were 400 people that had already come to vote at the library. They were expecting about 800 for today. Now, so far, they're just over 660 people, so they plan on surpassing their expectations there. And that's not just the case at the library. All polling places in Columbia are seeing more voters than they were expecting. Now, I also talked with officials to see how things have been going. They tell me it's been a smooth election so far. There were a couple of hiccups this morning with some scanners, but that was all cleared up very quickly.
Just the normal things of changing my address, or M100 wasn't like taking the ballots, and people were having to try several times, so they got us a new head for it and started, and it's been great since.
I've been speaking with those voting here today to kind of get an idea of what is getting them out to the polls. The majority of people tell me the big issue they wanted to weigh in on was Proposition 1. That is the property tax for public safety. Proposition 2 is another one people were talking about, which would raise developer fees to pay for Columbia roads. And people were also excited to vote for the 47th state representative between Democratic candidate John Wright and Republican Chuck Basie. Again, you still have 2 hours to make your vote count. And like I said earlier, voter turnout has been better than expected in Columbia, and that seems to be the case in Jefferson City, where ABC 17's Lindsay Henry is live with how voting is going there. Lindsay?
That's right. Cole County Clerk Marvin Register estimated about 34% of voters would turn out to the polls today. But as of 1 p.m. this afternoon, this polling place right behind me was already reaching those numbers, still with hours to go.
Oh, I think there's some real close races there. I really do. I just hope that it's more than 2% that they win by, so we don't have to have any recounts.
These polls opened up at 6 a.m., and so far a majority of the 36 countywide polling stations have been busier than the 34% expected turnout.
Turnout has really been really good. We're starting to have to take extra ballots to the polling places.
Register says the main reason voters are heading out to the polls this year is because of the people on the ballots.
There's a couple things on the change in Constitution and some people that I really wanted to see get into office.
Well, they're all important, but we had some major ones that we had to do some considering about and thinking on and make sure that they got in, the ones we wanted.
The three close races are expected to be for the 19th Circuit Judge, County Clerk, and Prosecutor. And regardless of who they voted for, everyone I spoke with at the polls agreed it's important to have your voice heard.
It's a right that you have as each citizen, and it's important to exercise it because then you have made your voice heard. And I believe that there are places in the world where they don't have that right, or it's taken away from them. And you would treat it more preciously if you lived in a place like that.
We really need to make sure that you take the opportunity to vote, so that you have, because you do have a vested interest, obviously, in the outcomes.
Remember, it's only 5 o'clock, so you still have 2 more hours to vote until 7 p.m. And if you're planning on going out to the polling stations, you need to remember you have to have either your voter's registration card or some sort of identification, like a driver's license, on you. Live in Jefferson City, Lindsay Henry, ABC 17 News.
All right, thank you, Lindsay and Heather.